Hey, welcome you to this fifth session on Azure Virtual Networking. I'm going to talk about something very important aspect of Azure Virtual Network, security. How can we secure inbound traffic and outbound traffic from and to a virtual machine? Yes, NSG does the same. How we create NSG inbound rules, outbound rules, so that we can allow HTTP traffic, we will be able to do RDP into the virtual machine. We are also going to see how the NSG can be connected to a subnet. So the list of all virtual machines in that subnet are protected. And of course, NSG can also be connected to the NIC of a specific VM. All these things you are going to see in action. We will definitely see practically every aspect which we have covered conceptually. But don't forget to put your comments so that I can understand what kind of experience you have gone through in this particular session. Network Security Group. What exactly is the purpose of this? Now this NSG, I'm going to attach with a subnet. And within the subnet, I'm going to create virtual machines where I'll have applications. Now this NSG is going to comprise of certain rules. We call them as inbound rules and outbound rules. Based on inbound rules, we will define what traffic should be allowed and what should not be allowed. Both we will have to give. From outside to inside, that is inbound. An outbound rule will be from inside to outside. So I will now create two NSGs, front-end NSG and back-end NSG. Front-end NSG I'll attach with the front-end subnet and back-end NSG I'll attach with the back-end subnet. Let's do that first. So go and search for NSG, Network Security Group. Create. Select the existing resource group. Now all the resources we create in the same resource group and same region. So I'll call it as front-end NSG. Likewise, you have to wait till create button enable. After clicking on create also, you'll have to wait till this screen goes away and new screen comes up. Don't try to jump. Now you do it. Now come back to NSG. It's taking time, so it's not reflected yet. Second one. Same resource group. I'll call it as backend NSG. Frontend NSG, backend NSG. Now these two NSGs, we have to connect to the subnet. Right now they are independent. How to connect to the subnet? There are two ways of doing it. One is you can go to the VNet, then go to the subnet, select a particular subnet, and here you can do it. With the front-end subnet, I have attached front-end NSG. Save it. This is one way. With the backend, I can select backend subnet. But alternatively, you can go to NSG. Backend NSG. We want to attach to subnet. So go and add it to the subnet here. Reverse. Associate with this subnet. Backend subnet. Remember, same NSG I can attach with multiple subnets and they can be of different VNets. The rule set can be reused. The rules I'm going to create here and those rules can be reused in multiple subnets of same VNet or different VNet. You can associate here. I have only one VNet, but otherwise we'll get multiple VNets and then the corresponding subnet. So two different ways, but point is the subnets are the ones which will have NSG. one subnet can have only one NSG. One NSG can go with multiple subnet, but one subnet will have only one NSG. Now, what is there in the NSG? Rules are there. Inbound security rules, outbound security rules. You will find these rules there. So go to inbound security rules. And there are three default rules. There are three rules which are by default there. We didn't even add it. So is the case with outbound security rules. Now, what are these three default rules? NSG rules are five tuple. A rule is made up of five tuples. Source IP, source port, destination IP, destination port, and port number and protocol. Source, destination, IP and port, and protocol. These five things together will create a rule. So here we are saying a rule called as deny all inbound request. From wherever the request comes, whatever is the protocol, right? Any source, any port, any protocol, we are denying it. We are not allowing it. But this is the lowest priority. This rule is of lowest priority. Better than this priority is this one. Smaller the value, better is the priority. Higher the priority. Smaller the value, higher is the priority. Reverse. Generally, when value is more, priority is more. But here, smaller is the value, higher is the priority. The next is, if the source from where the request is originating is load balancer, and if destination is anything, allow. And from anywhere within the VNet to anywhere within the VNet, allow. VNet to VNet, full control is given. No restriction. Likewise, you see outbound security. Outbound means from inside a VM of the VNet, of the subnet, to outside. When the request goes out, deny all outbound. Don't allow. Allow internet outbound. From here to internet, allow access. That's why I told you earlier in VNet characteristics. Every machine which is in the VNet, you will have access to internet by default. No, I don't want to allow. You can't even delete this. You have to just keep it like that. Or you create a new rule with better priority. And there you give deny. But you can't delete the built-in rules at least. Likewise, VNet to VNet outbound is also allowed. So VNet to VNet inbound is allowed. VNet to VNet outbound is allowed. And the rules are executed in the order of their priority. Smaller the value, higher the priority. The smallest possible value is 100. Highest priority is 100. Less than 100 we can't have. So like this, inbound rules, outbound rules. I want to create now two inbound rules here. I am assuming that in the front end, I am going to place two web servers. In back end, I am going to place two database servers. I should be able to do RDP, remote desktop access to these machines. RDP servers run on port number 3389. So I want to allow inbound rule 3389 traffic into the front end subnet. Inbound rule 80, which is for web server, I want to allow in the front end subnet. So how to do this? So we created the subnet. And now we have to create the rule. So for this, go to inbound rule, add any source, any port, I don't care from where the request comes, to any machine, and I want to allow port number 3389. Which protocol? RDP uses TCP protocol.
you have other options also. Do you want to allow or deny? Yes, I want to allow. And you can give the priority. Let's say 1000. Allow any custom RDP inbound. You can change that name if you want to. Now you don't remember this port number sometimes. Here there is a drop down they have given, helper drop down. You can simply select, say for example, I select MS SQL. 1433 is MS SQL port number by default. RDP is 3389. So you don't have to remember this number. 3389 TCP. But ultimately what we did earlier, the same thing is happening. Just that the UI is auto-filling these values. So one new rule is added. And exclamation is given. Actually, you should not allow RDP. You are exposing the machine to internet. And that too our machine has public IP. People can hack and get into this with random username and password. They would try and break it and get into it. Ransomware attacks most of the time on the machine happen through RDP port only. But if I don't enable RDP, I will not be able to log in into that particular machine. So let there be RDP for the timing, at least till we understand what is a better alternative. Likewise, I may want to have a web server here, which will be HTTP, port number 80, allow some priority and give the name. If you want, you can give description also for your helping purpose. So one more rule created. HTTP request should be allowed into the virtual machines which are placed in the subnet to which this frontend NSG is attached, which is frontend subnet. Frontend NSG is attached to frontend subnet. In frontend subnet, these rules are going to be taken care of. Inbound request, outbound request. So this is what I have done just now. These two things. Something similar I would like to do for my backend NSG, backend subnet. I want to allow SQL server request. And if you want to allow RDP, and I would like to deny all outbound internet requests. How to create these three? First, go to the backend subnet. Inbound security rule, add MS SQL 1433 TCP. I am okay with the name, allow. Like that, add one more. I want to allow RDP 3389 TCP, allow. Now I would like to configure outbound. Basically, my requirement is internet should be denied access. So I'll create an exactly same rule with deny and give a better priority. So I'll choose here destination. What should be the destination now? Entire internet we have to give. So simply choose here a service tag and choose in the destination service tag internet. These are all different PaaS services, platform as a service. All these are PaaS services in Azure. We want to give simple internet here. Destination port, any port, any source, any port of destination, but to internet, any protocol, I want to deny access. And give a priority which is value smaller than this number. Deny internet outbound. I'll just give that name. deny internet outbound. I can edit this, I can delete this, but point to be noted, port same, protocol same, source same, type destination same, but here it is deny, here it is allow. Because this rule will match first, this will never execute. Built-in rules cannot be deleted. You can override them with a high priority rule for a different action. So this is how we can create NSGs, create rules in the NSGs, and bind NSGs to the respective subnets. But are these things in action right now? Where will my traffic go? Unless I have a virtual machine, my traffic cannot go inside the VM. We need something like a virtual machine so that we can cross the subnet and go to VM. And let's do that in the next session. Thank you.